Hi guys, welcome to this video and we are going to make pajamas back. It's first part of tutorial and you will need pins with large head, measure tape, lot of hollow fiber and round elastic rubber band. I hope it's correct word for it. And you will need this fastening. And I have no idea what is called in English. In Czech, it's breaks. Breaks with two gaps. So let me know below the video if you know the right word for it in English. And you will need a pair of scissors, yarn needles, stitch markers, sewing thread, and 5 mm crochet hook. And of course you will need some material, so I'm going to use Chenille yarn. You will need 2 balls of this yarn. It's 100% polyester, it's 100 grams, 120 meters, and bulk is 6. And I will use this amazing Chenille yarn. It's called Dolphin Baby from Himalaya brand, and for me it's the best quality, but you can use any brand of this yarn, this type of yarn. And a link where you can buy yarns and needed things for this project will be in description of this video. And also you will need this amazing yarn. It's a yarn composed from these loops, so it will be a little different work. I think I will call it like knitting with fingers, because you don't need hooks, you don't need needles, just your fingers and both hands. And I will work with this yarn. It's called Puffy or Puffy from Alize brand, and it's so soft, it's so cozy material. I'm sure you will like it. Maybe you know knitting with fingers, without hooks, without needles. Maybe you know this type of yarn, so let me know and I will be very happy for any comment. And also you need 100% black cotton yarn for eyes of rabbit. Okay, first take the loop yarn and I'm going to make the body of rabbit or body of pajamas holder or pajamas back. And I think it's amazing idea, because your kid can put his pajamas inside the rabbit, and also it can be a great friend for sleeping, so I'm sure your kid will love it. Okay, now we need to cut the middle of few loops like this, so we need to make a tail. Okay, and then count 19 loops, and if you will need, or if you want to have narrow body, more narrow body, you can count less loops, for example 17, 18, or you can count 20, 21. It's up to you, but I'm going to count 19 loops. And then we will join it to the circle. So we need to get the circle from these loops and take the 19th loop and pull it through the first loop like this. And This is going to be all the pattern. So now you will take another loop from your working tail. You will take a following loop on the working tail, and you will just pull it to the following loop on the circle. I will call it circle, or yeah, I will call it circle. So I mean this loop on the circle, and just pull it through like this, and take every following loop and pull it through the loop on the circle. So take every following loop on working tail and pull the loop through the following loop on the circle. I hope it's understandable for you. If it's not, just let me know below the video and I will help you with pleasure. Or you can write me on my Instagram profile at the Miss Sheep. Okay, so continue working and meet me back again at the end of the round, of the first round. Okay, and next round will be exactly the same like first one. So just take every following loop from the working tail and pull it through every following loop on the circle. So it's very easy. It's nice work with this yarn. It's so soft, cozy. It's thicker yarn, so it will be quick work. So I hope you will like it. And you need just make sure you take every following loop and don't miss any loop. And also make sure that no loop is twisted. So it can be twisted like this. So just twist the loop back and then you can continue working. You can make also neck warmer or scarf like this if you want, or you can make something else like a blanket. Maybe hat, winter hat. It's up to you. So continue working and meet me back again when you will have 22 rounds, or when you will get the length of the body 40 or 41 centimeters. So 41 centimeters or 22 rounds. Okay, and we have done the body of rabbit. It looks like purl stitch when you knit. And it's so cozy, it's so soft. I think it's beautiful. And really your kid will love it. And on this body I worked with 19 loops, and with the same color of yarn I worked with 17 stitches. It looks different, so it's just tip from me when you will have the same color. Okay, and now we are going to make legs of rabbit. So take the chenille yarn and start with magic ring. If you don't know how to make magic ring, just click the link above or in description of this video. Then chain one and 5 single crochets into the magic ring, and the chain on the beginning. We will count like single crochets, so together you will get 6 single crochets. Chain 1 plus 5 single crochets in magic ring is 6. And then tighten the magic ring, so pull the starting tail and tighten it. And then we have to join the round with a slip stitch. And I'm going to use the first stitch, not the chain. So make a slip stitch in the first stitch. And now we are going to work in a round. So you should mark the beginning of round. And I'm going to hide this starting tail behind my work because it's more comfortable and easier for me. And I made 2 single crochets in the first stitch, then make 2 single crochets in the next stitch, and we will make 2 single crochets in each stitch all the way around. So at the end of the round, you should have 12 stitches. Okay, in the next round, we are going to increase every second stitch. So I'm going to make 2 single crochets in the first stitch. So this is 1 single crochet and 2 single crochets in the same space. And then make just 1 single crochet in next stitch. Then increase again, so make 2 single crochets in the next stitch. And continue working 2 single crochets in every second stitch all the way around. And at the end of the round, you should have 18 stitches. And always use stitch marker. And in the next round, we are going to make just 1 single crochet in each stitch all the way around. So it will be round without changes. And at the end of the round, you should have again 18 stitches. Okay, in next round, make 1 single crochet in each stitch all the way around again. So at the end of the round, you should have again 18 stitches. And now in next round, count 8 stitches, and these 8 stitches we are going to decrease. So you will decrease 4 times in this round. So make 2 single crochets together 4 times. So insert your hook into the next stitch, grab the yarn, pull it through, insert your hook into the next stitch. I'm going to do it again because it's stuck. Okay, so again, insert your hook into the next stitch, grab the yarn, insert your hook into the next stitch, grab the yarn. You have 3 loops on your hook, grab the yarn and pull it all 3 loops. And do it 3 more times. And this is last decrease. And then you will make just 1 single crochet in each stitch to the end. So you will make 1 single crochet in the next 10 stitches, and at the end of the round you should have 14 stitches. Okay, I'm at the end of the round, and in next round we will not increase, we will not decrease, so it will be round without chains. And in next round make just one single crochet in each stitch all the way around. At the end of the round you should have again 14 stitches. I'm at the end of the round and I'm going to finish the round with a slip stitch, and now we need to change the color of yarn. So it's up to you if you will do it like you always do, or if you will do it with invisible color change. And the link and single video you can find in description of this video or above the right corner. So I'm going to do it with invisible color change and make just one single crochet in each stitch all the way around. Okay, I'm going to make a slip stitch in the first pink stitch, and then I'm going to work in a round again. So I'm going to hide all tails behind my work and just make one single crochet in each stitch all the way around. But now it's time for stuffing. So stuff just the lower part of leg, just this part of leg, and not whole leg. Okay, and you will make just one single crochet in each stitch. So make one single crochet in each stitch all the way around and make 10 more rounds. And now I'm going to just finish the round with a slip stitch and start new round with chain one and then one single crochet in each stitch all the way around. And it's a last round of the leg. Okay, meet me back again. And at the end of the round, you have to make a slip stitch and finish the round. And that's all. You will make the second leg exactly the same. If you want to have longer legs, it's up to you, you can make more rounds. And now I'm going to show you how to make arms of rabbit. Take the chenille yarn and make magic ring. So we are going to start with magic ring and chain one. Then make 5 single crochets into the magic ring again. So we are starting exactly the same we made legs. And the chain on the beginning you will count again like single crochets. So together you will get 6 single crochets. Tighten the magic ring and then join the round with a slip stitch and make a slip stitch in the first stitch, not in chain. And we are going to work in a round, so use stitch marker again because you need to know where is the beginning of each round. and make two single crochets in the first stitch, and I'm going to hide the starting tail behind my work again. And in this round you will increase every stitch, so make two single crochets in each stitch all the way around, and at the end of the round you should have 12 stitches. And in this part of tutorial I will show you just how to make legs, arms and the body of rabbit, and in next part of tutorial I will show you how to make head, ears and the face of rabbit, and also how to sew individual parts together. So I hope you liked the video and you will watch also the second part of tutorial, because I think it's the most important. Okay, I'm going to finish the second round, and in next round we will increase again. And in next round we will increase every second stitch. So in the first stitch make two single crochets, and in next stitch make one single crochet. In the next stitch make two single crochets again. So in every second stitch make two single crochets, and continue working like this all the way around, and at the end of the round you should have 18 stitches. Okay, now in the next two rounds we will not decrease, we will not increase, so make just one single crochet in each stitch all the way around, and make two rounds of single crochets. Okay, now we are going to decrease, and you will decrease every second stitch, so make two single crochets together and then make just one single crochet in next stitch, then decrease again, so make two single crochets together. In next stitch make one single crochet, and continue working like this around, and at the end of the round you should have 12 stitches. Okay, you can see last decrease and first decrease, and between them you have to make one single crochet. So one single crochet in the very last stitch. And now use hollow fiber just in this part of arm. Don't fill the whole arm by hollow fiber, because it will not look nice. And now in the next round we have to change the color of yarn. So I'm going to finish the round with a slip stitch, and now I'm going to change the color with the easier way. So you can change the color of yarn with your favorite way. It's up to you. So I'm going to just make a chain one with the pink color of yarn and then make one single crochet in each stitch all the way around and like I always do, I'm going to hide the tail behind my work. So I started the round with chain one, so I need to finish the round with a slip stitch and then I will work in a round again. So I'm at the end of the round. I'm going to make a slip stitch and now I will work in a round. So make just one single crochet in each stitch all the way around and make 10 rows together. I'm going to use just a little more hollow fiber. Okay, I have done 10 rounds of single crochets and now I'm going to finish the round with a slip stitch and then chain one and then one single crochet in each stitch around and that's all. And at the end of the round, I have to make a slip stitch. And slip stitch. And that's all. You will make exactly the same way also the second arm of rabbit. Okay, how I said, don't fill it whole arm. You can use hollow fiber in the middle of arm, just little, and that's all. And you can see difference. This is invisible color change and this is normal way how to change colors. So this is nicer, I think. And that's all from me for today. I hope you like the video, you like tutorial and you like my rabbit. And have a lovely day. See you soon.